and to praise your holy and righteous and everlasting name. For it was you and you alone who awakened us this morning with the blood running warm in our veins. So we give thanks for all you do, and with prayer we thank you in advance for blessings yet to come. Start this and they'll get the music for
me. Amen.
Okay. My own personal meaning of Christmas is the love of Christ, the compassion and passion of Christ. Can you imagine? Can you just imagine being there to witness such beautiful clear skies and seeing this gleaming star that was sent down from heaven? On that beautiful and winter night, a child was born in Bethlehem in a manger, a precious baby boy, and his parents had received the word from God to call his name Jesus. Jesus was a blessing brought forth by God, and he was God's only son, his only child, who entered into this earth to save not only me, but all of us.
Amen.
Who believe in him, and that he would save all of us from our sins.
Amen.
Many people rejoiced that night knowing he was the Messiah, the branch of the root of Jesse. Some may say from the tender stem has sprung Jesse's lineage. Come and he will reign over all nations, bringing peace to the world.
Amen.
Isaiah chapter 11, verse 1. For Jesus is the Prince of Peace, the coming King, the wonderful Counselor. With praise and glory for Jesus took the burdens of this earth and placed it upon his shoulders. He taught us how to love ourselves, but also our neighbors.
Amen.
He taught us how to pray without ceasing, to forgive us of our sins so that we may forgive others.
Amen.
And to come and follow him, so that we may have abundance of life and to have life eternal. Jesus brought light to the world, a light to shine not only upon us, but also within us, so that we can share with others who do not know him. Not only was he a rabbi, but also a teacher, a shepherd. A teacher to teach us the true meaning of life, the meaning of love, and the meaning of prayer. So to me, the true meaning of Christmas is Jesus Christ of Nazareth, our Lord and our Savior, the Messiah, Hosanna in the highest.
Amen.
Oh, come, let us adore him, Christ the Lord. His birth and life is a message of good news for us all. We don't have to worry about having to travel through life with our struggles, though our challenges alone. For Jesus understands.
Because he lived it. He walked through it. And never once complained. Not even when he was crucified on that old rugged cross. In the book of John chapter 3 verse 16 and 17. For God so loved the world that he sent his only son, that whosoever believes in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life.
Amen, amen.
For God did not send his son into the world to condemn the world, but to save the world through him. In the book of St. Luke chapter 2 verse 10, Jesus said, do not be afraid, for I bring good news that will cause great joy. Great joy for all people. We are never alone. God walks with us. God talks with us. He is in front of us, behind us, and the back of us. God surrounds us. So let us give thanks for the love, the hope, and joy found in our blessed Savior. For me, true Christmas means a child was born, unto us a son was given, and the government will be upon his shoulders. Jesus is the bright and morning star, the King of kings, the Lord of lords, the lily of the valley. So let us be glad and joyful and thank God for his son. Jesus the Christ, let us give him the praise and the glory he most richly deserves. Christmas is a time to be grateful for what we have. For we live by faith and not by sight.
That's right, man.
Our faith in God, which sustains us so that we can continue to walk with Jesus and continue to talk with Jesus. For come, all ye faithful, joyful, and triumphant. Oh, come and let us adore him, Christ the Lord. I would like to thank you. May the peace and the love of God be with you all. And I want everyone to have a safe, secure, and a Merry Christmas.
Thank you.
All praise be to God for giving us his son and our Savior, Jesus Christ of Nazareth.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Joy to the world, the Lord has come. Let earth receive her King. Let every heart prepare him room. And heaven and nature sing. And heaven and heaven nature sing.
Amen.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Yes, indeed.
Let's lift his name up.
Amen.
Amen.
Let's lift his name.
Amen. Amen.
Yes.
Brother Kareem. Work it out. Can you put it back a little bit? Just a little bit. That's too much. The great I am gave his son for every man, the atonement for sin and shame. Accept his righteousness, and you will be blessed with a life more abundantly. Don't throw your life away on the evils of today. They'll only lead you to suffering and pain. Set your mind on things above and receive his precious love. You'll be happy to lift his name and say,
He is all my righteousness.
Yes.
I stand complete in him. There is no other name I praise and adore. It's you my heart longs for.
We praise you for your love, for your mercy that has no end. You're the God of hope. You destroy every yoke. By your Spirit we are set free. There is none like you in all of the earth. There's all power in your hand. You raise the dead.
be all the glory.
Thus, we believe. We believe.
God. God is. God is. God is.
God
man.
Thank everybody for coming out today. We're going to move forward. I really enjoyed today. Thank you so much. Before I hand it over to the deacons to take charge, and I want Lloyd and Tanisha to come on up. I want Brianna to come on up to the front.
Thank you, Lord.
God did a mighty great thing.
Thank you, Lord.
Mighty great thing. Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Everything. Yes.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Oh, I thank you.
On last year, last New Year's, we had a baptism on New Year's Eve. Monera and Kyle got baptized together. And then a few months later, they got married at the altar. They went to the board, and they came right here and got married. And, but Rihanna came, and she came with Monera, and shortly after talking with her, she said, I want to get baptized. And I want to get baptized on New Year's Eve, too. So Rihanna, Lord willing, this coming New Year's Eve, we give her life to the Lord Jesus Christ, and she'll be going to the water.
Amen.
Amen. And then we have a couple, a great couple that I really love, and Lloyd and Tanisha Dixon, the friends of Rhonda Langston. Ministering to them, and then in talking to them, enjoying my talk with them every week, I believe for a couple months now, and they decided to give, they decided to join.
Amen.
Our family.
Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah.
And Lloyd decided to go to the water, give their life to the Lord Jesus Christ.
Thank you.
Amen. On New Year's Eve.
Thank you.
Amen. And to have their newborn Christian and dedicated to the Lord as well. And also Rayana's son, little Raymond, will be dedicated to the Lord. So we got two baptisms and two dedications on New Year's Eve. Start the New Year's Eve church. Amen. Amen. I think we can make it happen.
Hallelujah.
All right. I think they go to the water around 7:30.
Yeah.
Then we can go on from there. How about that?
Yeah.
I thank God for them being here today.
Hallelujah. Thank you.
Sister Rhonda Langston, God bless you.
Amen.
God bless you mightily and greatly. You're a great woman of God, and you're very unselfish. And God is using you. God can continue to use you for His glory. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much for the work of the Lord. This is fruit and evidence of the work of the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Well, as if y'all have anything to say, we're going to have the baptism and the dedication. And on Thursday, Sunday, we're going to give you the right hand of fellowship.
Amen.
And the certificate Amen. And everything like that. So that way, you don't be like Sandy and say, oh, where am I? I said, where am I? She got it done. Amen.
Amen.
Thank
Amen.
God for her as well. So you're going to get the right hand of fellowship, and you're going to get your certificate and everything like that. But on New Year's Eve, you're going to get your baptism and things like that, and get a word from the Lord, get your presentations and all. And we're going to have a good time there. So now, if you actually have anything or if you have to say.
Always. Thank you, Jesus. He is great. He never stops working. So there will always be something to say. There will always be things to give.
Amen.
In His holy name.
Amen.
I'm so grateful for New Rehoboth and every member here. I've always been greeted with love, nurturing, and just something to go on about my week with. Being here every Sunday, as many Sundays as I can make it, it's always very impactful. It's something I can never forget.
Amen. Praise God.
It's the unexplainable feeling, so I hope that you all are able to channel what it is that I'm expressing. But just give thanks to God. Amen. Glory be to Him.
Amen. Amen.
Yes, I want to give thanks to God. Thanks to my family. Thanks to all my friends. Everybody that came out. And it's been a long road. It's been been very hard. But by the grace of God, we got here.
Amen.
And I'm just thankful. Just thankful for everything that He's done. Just thankful.
Amen.
I just have to say, thank you to Rhonda and Pastor Yarbrough for, pushing us forward and getting us on the right path. And we're excited to join New Rehoboth.
Amen.
As our new family church. And just thank you all for always being so welcoming when we're coming in the door and making us feel, like a safe place. And it's, just thankful. And we can't be thankful enough.
Amen.
We're so thankful to have. Let's give them a round of applause and praise God. Amen. Amen. I'm not going to hold you real long and put it in the hands of the deacons, and then may have a couple announcements after that. Be ready to go from there. Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen.